Hey everyone, it's Mark Wiens with migrationology.com and eatingthaifood.com. I am about to make a recipe for ำพร กกะป, which is the Thai shrimp paste chili dip. And it is extremely popular and widely available throughout Thailand. And I made a video, you've probably seen me eating it a couple of times, and many of you have asked for the recipe. So finally, here is the recipe for ำพร กกะป.A couple weeks ago, I was in Samut Sakhon, which is about an hour from Bangkok on the coast, and they are extremely famous throughout Thailand for their some of the best quality shrimp paste. And so I was there, I bought a bunch of good quality shrimp paste, and actually it's made from krill, which are tiny little shrimp-like little creatures that are salted and left in the sun, and then they are fermented for months and even years.And then that is shrimp paste. So it is extremely popular in Thailand and used in many different dishes, but probably the purest way to eat kaphi or shrimp paste is in ำพร กกะป. I got the shrimp paste here and I'm gonna be using about 2 tablespoons. I already pre-lit some charcoal, but I've got a little like grill grate and I'm just gonna set the ball of, maybe flatten it out a little bit. And I'm just gonna set the shrimp paste on there just to, this is just gonna bring out kind of a smoky fragrance in the shrimp paste. Okay, and then after a couple seconds, you can just flip it over. Oh, and you can see like that little bit of, it looks like a little hamburger. It has been just a couple minutes. This is looking perfect. I'm gonna take it off now and I'm just gonna, oh, it smells so good. I'm just gonna put it right back into that little bowl. Patty, oh, that's hot.I forgot to tell you at the beginning of this recipe, but ำพร กกะป can be eaten with all sorts of things in Thailand. Especially popular is boiled vegetables and raw vegetables, and also fish and omelets, and just eat it with your rice. But I've got a few vegetables that I'm gonna boil, and I've also got a duo of mackerel with the bent heads, which are absolutely delicious. And sometimes they are fried, but since I have the charcoal going, I'm just gonna roast them over fire and then I'm gonna eat them with the ำพร กกะป once it's done. I'm gonna use a whole head of garlic. I usually take a mallet like this and just give them a quick smash. And then yeah, just peel off all that skin real fast. That's it. Okay, garlic is all peeled and the next most important ingredient are chilies. You cannot make a ำพร in Thailand without chilies. In Thai, they are called phrik kinu suan, and these are just little Thai chilies, but they definitely pack a pretty beautiful, spicy punch to them. So I'll just pull off the stems. I think that's about 35 or 40 chilies, but they're really small. So next, I'm just gonna add a couple of shallots. So just slice off the ends, and then peel off all that skin. Okay, that should be good. These are Thai shallots, so they're pretty small, but they have just a beautiful oily, oiliness and delicious flavor. And they're used in so many different Thai dishes, especially curry pastes and chili sauces. Okay, before I get started pounding, I'm just gonna throw my mackerel onto the fire. I am a huge fan of mackerel. They are so good. And I'll just set these in here. Next step, just take your mortar and pestle, and you really gotta do this by hand. This is key to making ำพร ก. So I'm gonna just toss in all of the garlic and chilies and the shallots. It's probably gonna take 10 minutes or so because you really wanna get it really nice and fine, break down all those oils and all those chilies. Oh, I lost a shallot there. And really get it nice and fine so that it blends into the shrimp paste. Okay. I've been pounding for probably about 10 minutes and I think we are just there. That's exactly what you're looking for. It's reduced to kind of not a really fine paste, but a nice coarse fragrant paste, and that looks perfect. Okay, the next step is I'm gonna add a couple of pea eggplant, and these are common in Thailand, but it's not completely necessary. This is sort of just for looks. It doesn't give a lot of flavors to it. So if you don't have it, no problem. throw them in there, probably about, I lost one again, okay, and just probably about 8 or 10 or so, and then I'm just gonna give them just a quick, just a really light pound. You can hear them kind of popping open. Okay, that should be good. Now I am going to go in with the shrimp paste and all of the shrimp paste that we roasted earlier, all of that in, and I've got a little bit of palm sugar to balance the saltiness and the spiciness, and probably about a half a spoon. That should be good. And yeah, I'll probably give it a quick pound real fast, but just kind of work that shrimp paste a little bit into the chilies and garlic. Yeah, you can actually take out the mallet or the pestle and just kind of mix it up with a spoon now. And actually you could mix this in a bowl too, but I think it's cooler to mix it in the mortar. Okay, and I'm gonna slice the limes now. I'm gonna start with 2 limes. Okay, squeeze that lime juice right in there. I'm gonna squeeze them all in. Now is the point when you must taste test just to see what else it needs and how the balance of flavors is. Oh, that is starting to taste extremely good, but it's a bit salty, so I need to add some more lime juice. Prik Kapi is definitely something that you have to taste test and just kind of feel out the flavors for yourself. I've done a few more taste tests, but it is looking perfect right now. It's salty, it's spicy, it's sour, and everything is well balanced. At this point, you could put it into a bowl, but I'm just gonna serve it right out of the mortar, and I'm just gonna top it with some more chilies. So you'll often see that people just throw on some chilies on the top just to make it look good. And then every time you get a bite with a full chili, it's just like an absolute dynamite bite that is beautiful. It's pretty good. And maybe I'll toss on a few pea eggplants just for fun. Looks like the blatu, the mackerel, are finished. These are looking beautiful. Oh, they're gonna taste so good with that chili sauce. Okay, and these are ready to go. Now we just gotta boil the vegetables. I've got a pot of water, and I'm gonna put it onto my street food cart. I'm just gonna quickly boil these vegetables. I've just got okra and bitter melon, but really you can use any type of vegetable you have. All right, that looks about good. Turn off the gas. And I'll just fish all of these vegetables out. The components of this classic Thai meal are all ready, and so I'm sitting down to eat. For my first bite, I'm just gonna grab an okra and dip it straight in. Oh, that looks so good. Okay. Oh, that's marvelous. It's salty, it's sour, it's spicy and garlicky as well. Yeah, that is like all of the best flavors in a single sauce. I'm just gonna break off some of his side, and I'm gonna put that over on my other side of rice, I guess. And then just, oh, this meat is so buttery and oily and wonderful. Put this over onto my other side of rice. Yeah, go in with my spoon this time, get some of those little chilies as well, and just generously anoint that fish. Okay, and then get a little bit of rice with some of that Prik Kapi, and oh, that fish is so buttery and creamy. And then with that Prik Kapi, oh, that is stunning. That's it for the recipe. It's actually pretty easy to make as long as you have all of the ingredients, especially that shrimp paste, and it's a great way to eat a lot of vegetables. But this is about as classic or as everyday of a meal as it comes in Thailand. Be sure to click below. You'll find a link to the full recipe for all the details about how you can make this. And thank you very much for watching this video. Be sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you know anybody who loves to cook Thai food, be sure to share this video and this recipe with them. I would really appreciate it. And thank you very much for watching.